imagine there's no heaven. It's easy if you try. No hell below us. Above us, only sky.
Hey, so it's me, Eric.
And Megan.
And we're just here to say happy birthday and tell you, Dad, how much we love you. And just wanted to say thanks for all the great memories and all the things you taught me. I learned everything I know from you. Well, most of the things I know from you. So you taught me everything I know, but not everything you know. Ah.
And you taught him very well. You taught him how to treat a woman, and I greatly appreciate that. So thank you. And happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Dad. We love you. Happy birthday.
Where do I even begin? And somehow I've got to put it all into one little clip. That's pretty hard to do. The time that you helped me teepee my friend's house, Nicholas Dean Selly's house, and Lindsay and Janet and I were there. And you didn't help us, but you took us, and you were there for us when we got caught. The beauty pageants, you know? walking me on the stage, you know, when you and I the night before practiced for hours on hours, and I ended up winning. And it was, you know, a great memory because you walked me on the run, on the runway. The ski trip, when a girl's ski went right into my head, you zoomed me down. I felt like it was 150 miles per hour. I thought that you had saved my life, and you know, you did. You rushed me to the hospital. I had to have stitches, but you were right there for me.
Dad, you do nothing normal. You picked me up in a limo at the airport from college. Not once, a couple of times. Yes. What dad does that? Nah, you're cool. You do not conform. And to me, that is one of the greatest gifts you bestow on me. That and hard work. And you've lived a life full of success, being true to you and always wanting the best for your family. It was the small things that I remember that made it so sweet. I have very, very fond memories of my childhood and adulthood. I'm not sure how I got so lucky to have such a unique, I'd say unique is a good word for that, funny and fun dad like you. I always felt safe and that we would always have what we needed. Thank you, Daddy. And in my adult years, you've always been a source of good advice, especially when it came to being an athlete and how to get ready for a race. I think of one of my favorite feel-good races was because I took your advice in eating just salads for 3 long weeks before my second marathon. That was a great race. Let's not forget, Dad, that we've done a race together too. You, me, Annette, and Ty, doing the Roy Webster Columbia Cross Channel Swim together up here in Hood River, Oregon. That was a blast, and that was the best last place race I've ever done, and I've had only two. Ha ha. We can forget about the pneumonia that you got from that race. I love you, Daddy-O, and I hope you have the best 80th birthday ever. And I love you forever and forever.
In times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. And in my hour of darkness, she is standing right in front of me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. Let it be, let it be, let it be, let it be. Whisper words of wisdom, let it be.
Hi, Dad. I just want to tell you that one of my favorite things I've learned from you is how important your mindset is. You've always said that if you think you can or you think you can't, you're right. And that's where everything begins. And I'm so appreciative that you taught me how to lose and how to lose gracefully, because you lose a lot in life and you have to keep going forward. So I am grateful that you've always taught me to try to discipline my mind, that it's okay to lose. It's okay to be at the bottom, because that doesn't mean that you'll always be there. So I love you so much, and I'm glad that I can call myself your favorite daughter. Happy birthday. I love you, Dad.
Guys, is your new house?
Yeah. Are you looking for a house, or are you looking for somebody to take it, or are you just enjoying the scenery? Which is it, ma'am?
Congratulations.
Hi, daughter.
Hi, how
daughter
you
Annette. Good. You want to come on in and see the inside of the house?
2509 Dewberry Court.
Your mother's in there too.
When we were younger, somehow we were in the Portland house on Hillcrest Drive, and we were gonna have this big, massive water balloon fight, and the whole neighborhood was gonna get involved, and they did. so many memories from Portland House. Do you remember all the snow sledding down the hill? Anyway, back to my water balloon story. We were going to have two teams, and so it was probably about 15 or 20 people, you know, from the neighborhood. And so you and I and Eric, we went and bought all these water balloons, and we filled them up, and we worked on it for a couple days at least, filling these water balloons. We had hundreds of them, probably close to 1,000 water balloons, literally. And you had taken, we went and got these buckets, and we went and we found these posts or whatnot, like bases or places that we put them into the woods. And so we had them to where we could go, and we had these buckets full of water balloons. And we went really early on a Saturday morning. We put them all out there, so that way when our team would start, we would be ready. Well, guess what? It just kind of became a all for one or one for all. Everybody was out for themselves. So there was no team against anybody else. It was just everybody was throwing water balloons at each other. It was a lot of fun. And then nobody else really did it. So everybody was just using the water balloons that we filled, but that was okay because it was cool. And then somehow everybody knew that they had to come up to the Portland House at the end. That's just where the end of the water balloon fight was going to be. And there were even more water balloons. Like, you had this big, huge garbage can that we had filled probably another 400 or 500 water balloons completely for everyone to just use. And so everybody came up to the house, the Portland House, the top, remember that steep driveway? And everybody just started grabbing those water balloons and throwing them at each other. But just when you think that the water balloon fight and that that's an awesome story, which it was, you never did anything half-assed, Dad. So what did you do? But you came out. Remember the Portland House had this deck that went around it. And you came out. I don't know how you got it or I don't know where, but you came out with this yellow fireman suit on. You had the fluorescent yellow hat. You had the yellow boots that went up to your knees. And you had a hose in your hand. And you started spraying us all down. You sprayed down all the neighbors and the neighbors' kids. I mean, there must have been at least 25 to 30 people there. It was pretty epic. And that's how it ended, was this water fight. And you had your hose. So epic. Happy 80th birthday.
Hi, Daddy-O, King David. Dad, you were there for both of my graduations. Tyla's baby blessing, Tucker's baptism when he was 8, and you drove up to support me in my first marathon in Sun River, Oregon. You supported me and trusted me when I decided to marry a guy I had just met 5 weeks before when I went to BYU, Idaho, and you gave him your blessing, not even meeting him, before the wedding, one day before the wedding. Point being, Dad, you've been my biggest cheerleader and have always tried to be there emotionally and physically for me during my milestones. But even for the smaller things, like going on a motorcycle road trip with Ty, walking Seaside, Oregon and the Oregon Zoo with my young family, taking Elijah to a Jesuit LaSalle awesome high school football game and got a football full of signatures there for him, telling us about coaching Joey Harrington, who eventually won the Heisman Trophy. I'm so proud to be your daughter, Dad. You've got some great success stories.
Dad, some of my favorite memories with you is at bedtime. You always made it so fun by tickling us and making us giggle. You even told the best stories, including how tall is a Chinaman. And I never got that until like 20 years later, by the way. You also helped me win student council body president in 7th grade at a school with 7th, 8th, and 9th graders. So I beat everybody out because you helped me decorate every single locker in the school and put posters everywhere to vote for me. And I won. I didn't know what I was doing after that point, but it was cool. I won because of you. And then you're also a huge supporter of me for all my marathons and races. And I love the fact that you flew all the way out to Santa Rosa not that long ago to watch me qualify for Kona. Dad, I always take it as a huge compliment when people say that I'm just like you and that I act like you and I look like you. There's nobody else I would want to be like. I love you, Dad.
Hello, Dave. This is Gary. Happy almost 80th birthday. I'm speaking to you from our side yard, and we own back beyond where these trees are, and it's a cool, kind of a warm day here. But I was asked to come up with one of my memories with you. And of course there are many, but I'm thinking of one right now, and that's when you decided, after we had climbed to the top of Saddle Mountain, that the best way down was the direct way, right down the face of the mountain, which we struggled to get down, and we luckily made it without losing our lives. And there were other things that happened that were interesting too. But anyway, I hope everything is going good with you and everybody else in your family. Our property here, you can't see it from here, but we're above the Rose City Golf Course. I wonder if you've ever golfed there. We're about 15 feet higher than the golf course, and our property fronts the golf course. So we see the golfers way down there trying to golf. Another thing we also see on the golf course is coyotes. We have a family of coyotes that has a den along the side of the golf course. And we have other wildlife here. It's kind of, we're in the middle of the urban area of Portland, but it's kind of halfway rural looking here. So anyway, hopefully everything is going well and you make it to 90. So again, happy almost birthday.
Hey Coach Faulkner, hey Dave. Say hi to your wife Sue. Hey, Steve Fex here. I want to tell one quick story for you. I'm going to come see you soon. All right. But every morning, you used to come pick me up before school. I'd walk up the highway, and you'd pick me up. We'd go to school before, wrestling practice, and we'd run the 3-mile loop. All right. And you were a marathon runner, and I was a freshman. The last half, about a quarter of a mile of that run was straight uphill, 300 second hill. And you used to sprint up that sucker. You'd beat me so bad up the hill, you'd get all the way to the top, come back halfway, be running in place, encouraging me, yelling at me, come on, let's go, let me catch you. And then we'd race to the back door of the locker room, which you'd crush me every day. And I used to think, man, Coach Faulkner is a machine. Who is this guy? Anyway, but man, I tell you, you always went the extra mile with me and every kid you ever coached. That's why I became a coach, because of you, Dave. Anyway, I'm going to come see you soon. And I got some more stories on you that I'm going to tell. But I wanted to say hi and come see you soon. I'll bring you some Tomcat gear, because I need you to wear that Tomcat gear on Friday night, because I need some Coach Faulkner luck for sure this year. Talk to you soon, Coach. Bye.
Hey, Dave. Happy birthday. I didn't know people got that old. Anyway, how's Chi-Chi doing? You remember Chi-Chi? You know, I thought you would be on the PGA golf tournament by now. Anyway, I'm still recovering from the years of following you around as you drug me around when we ran every morning and evening at your house, and I was out of gas and couldn't keep up with you. So anyway, happy birthday, and remember fishing at Diamond Lake? Remember that? Another thing that's interesting is I never got to Goat Rocks. Okay, I don't know what's on Goat Rocks, but it must have been really something fantastic because you constantly talked about it. I never got there. Anyway, you've been a good friend and have many good memories, and hope you're doing well.
Hi, Dave. This is Lynette, Gary and Alice Spears' daughter, and just wanted to send love to you on your birthday and your family. We think of you every 4th of July and miss you guys a lot. And my quick story is that Dave was my driver's ed teacher, which was fun. And being that I'm Gary's daughter, I could have been in for a lot of trouble. But as I recall, you only led me down a one-way street the wrong way one time. So I think all in all, I got off pretty easily. But anyways, want to wish you a very happy birthday, and wish I would have had the understanding and maturity when I saw you, but I want to thank you for your service. And I didn't know that when I could see you, so I wanted to tell you now. So lots of love to you and your family. Bye-bye.
Grandchildren. Hey, Dave. Hey, Dave. Just wanted to wish you a happy birthday. I don't know if you remember me. I'm younger, Gary, much younger, and Trina. We're here in Idaho. We actually moved Dad here a few years ago so I can keep him out of trouble. So he's keeping him busy. But anyway, just remembered a couple things that that I thought was fun. I guess my first question is, have you ever lost Heather again? You know, I remember at the beach, we got to the pizza place and had fun and then got back to the house and all of a sudden you and Sue realized you were down one child. So I'm hoping you haven't lost anybody else since then. But anyway, the other thing I think that was fun that I remember doing was, it was the Model T or Model A that you had. And I can remember going out on the parade route with you guys and then we were trying to get it back home and it wouldn't make it up the hill. And you had to park it at a neighbor's house. So that was one of the fun memories. So anyway, again, have a happy birthday and take care. Bye.
Hey, Coach. Steve Fex here again. Hey, got one more story to tell you today. And this is a different age back when we went to school. And you were my teacher. But you used to always, you know, scare everybody. You'd take all the staples out of the stapler. And you'd say, hey, let's see how tough you are. Hold your hand out. And you'd pretend like you were going to put a staple in their hand. And they, some of them would jump and some would stay there, but there was no stapler. Well, one day you called me up there and you said, hey, Bex, let's see how tough you are. Put your hand out there. I bet you're going to move it. I bet you're going to move it. And we were laughing, you know. And I was like, go ahead, Coach, go ahead. I'm tougher. And you hit that stapler and you put a staple right in the palm of my hand. Oh, my. It shocked me. Okay, but funny, different time, right? So a couple days later, I was going to get even. And so I put a tack on your chair. And this was remedial math class. I was a freshman, not very good at math. There was all these senior boys in there that were not top 10 honor students, right? And I put a tack on your chair, and you jumped up. Everybody laughed, and I was in the back, you know, hiding my face and being real quiet, and you knew it was me. So the next day we were doing an assignment and you're walking around helping students and you were whispering all these senior boys' ears. And the next thing I know, you yell, now, and all those senior boys jump up, grab me. It was an old science room, had a sink in it. And they take me over, stick my head in the sink and turn the cold water on. We laughed. We had a lot of fun, Coach. It, like I said, back in 1977, it was a different time, but man, I love you. And you made every day fun. You made every one of us want to be great. And you made every one of us want to be a lot like Dave Faulkner, man. Like I said, that's why I'm a coach. But there's two stories I got on you. And I got a whole bunch more. But I'll see you guys soon, okay? Bye. What a wonderful world.
I see skies of blue and clouds of white. The bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Happy birthday, dear Grandpa.
The colors of the rainbow. So pretty in the sky, or also on the faces of people going by.
You did it. I love you.
I love you.
We love you.
We love you.
I love you.
I love you.
I love you.
I love you.
We love you.
I 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 love you.
There are much more.
I love you, Grandpa.
David, and I think to myself, I am in love with you, and I am in love forever with you.
Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful.